'Tis the season to be jolly.
I think that's how it goes. Or that could have been the Christmas Stories version. Either way, today we go from one Range Rover into another. I woke up this morning, I looked out the window and I was like, bloody hell, if it ain't a beautiful day for a car review. Made some calls, old school, got onto our good friends, the Gaddies, and they said, yes, Vadim, come and take our 2016 Range Rover for a spin. And that's where we're going, people. You don't have to be a car nut to know that Range Rovers are expensive. They're expensive when you buy them, they're expensive when you fix them, and they cost you a lot of money when you sell them because you don't make very much money back. They have a huge depreciation problem. I mean, damn, there's deer running across the road back there. Shit, son. It could have been Santa. Anyway, I got real excited then. You can't half tell someone's excited about Christmas, can you? Anyway, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the 2016 Range Rover. Is 2016 Range Rover supercharged model, long wheelbase, and they're bloody good looking SUVs if you ask me. I'm a fan of them, but they do have a hefty price tag that comes with them. Just a measly about 110-120 grand. If you happen to have 120 grand laying around, maybe you can get yourself one of these. It's pretty. It's got the running boards that come out when you get close to the car. They are the factory 21-inch alloy rims with a monstrosity set of calipers to stop this big tank. They are huge. Let's go and take a look inside the 2016 Range Rover. And it is beautiful. Now, how sexy is that? Full length moonroof, sunroof, whatever you want to call it. It's a beautiful interior. And being the long wheelbase, you've got a shitload of room back there. Very stylish interior. I like it. It's somewhat simple, but elegant. As you can see, it's all touch button stuff these days. Indicators and lights, and then of course your wipers, your Triptronic or paddle shift options, all your mode options for the stereo, cruise control, heated steering wheel. Psh, gotta have that. Good work, Range Rover, putting in the heated steering wheel. Oh, yes, please. Just in case your little hands get cold. Start procedure, foot on the brake. So at some point, and I think it was about 2014, Range Rover chose to go with this little knob thing that does actually sink into the housing unit here, so it is level or flat. And basically that is how you change from park, reverse, and is your backup camera, very nice. Neutral, drive, and sports. Really is a beautiful setup in here. Here is your touchscreen infotainment system. You've got your home parking assist. Again, this is your camera. It'll give you a view of the vehicle from above, just in case you're backing up and there is a little grandma behind you. It's so you don't squash her, because that would be terrible. Obviously different mode options, music, phone, navigation. In the home sequence, you can go left or right. This is basically your home screen at the moment. You've got your in control app set up, audio setting, screen off, take me home, your nav or near current position. And you've got your 4x4 options, ambient lighting, auto parking aid, cameras. They do have stealth mode just in case you're going to war. A Wi-Fi hotspot, that's pretty cool. Okay, so that is the touchscreen infotainment system in a snap. Down here we have the climate control, and it is very simplistic, people. I don't need to school you on how to use a climate control system. The good people at Range Rover didn't miss a thing. They thought of everything. So obviously it's hard to see, but there are little diagrams within here that give you options for how you would like your Range Rover to be set up. Here we have the climbing Mount Everest option. If you are taking your Range Rover to Mount Everest, be sure to use this mode here. This is your traction control button. That is your ATPC function. Here you have the height. You can choose the height of the Range Rover. You want to be low riding, press it down low, and you can lock it in place. The ASL and the auto start stop feature off. And let's go and check out the back. Oh, and another beautiful thing about Range Rover is that when you close the door, if you don't close it properly, it closes itself for you. Man, we have become lazy. Let's mosey on into the back seat and I'll be bloody damned. Have a look at the amount of room. This is craziness. Have a look at the amount of room in this thing. I gotta tell you, this is the biggest back seat I have ever come across. Nice little center console area for the second row passengers. And usually I'd say you're in economy class when you're back here. This ain't no economy class, people. Climate control for the rear passengers, business class. This is definitely business class back here. I would never say this is economy class, because it ain't. This is beautiful back here. Whew, damn. Plenty of room, nice features, comfortable. I mean, you can't ask for much more than that. Now, it is hard to see, but this is all illuminated around here, and that at night would look very delicious. Oh, what the hell is this? Oh, look at that. What the hell do you put in there? What the hell is that for? I have no idea. What the hell do you put in there? I'm confused. Like, what? Is this? I don't want to pull this too hard because I don't want to break it, but what do you put in there? Dual speaker setup, windows, blinds, and these are some serious blinds, ladies and gentlemen. This is no like pull them up and nah. This is like royalty sort of stuff here. All right, let's check out the back. A great looking ass end on this Range Rover. Supercharged sign. And you know what I love about modern cars? They're all designed to just avoid any manual labor whatsoever. Because why? It's overrated. Who wants to lift a tailgate? Not me. So, you know. Modern technology is really contributing to the obesity problem in this world. There is a perfect example. Time to take the old Range Rover for a spin. Oh, there it is. Beautiful start. Oh, the steering wheel's moving down. The car already knows how I want it set up. I love that feature. Okay, let's take the old girl for a drive. It's got a very smooth ride. The seat is quite encumbersome. It feels almost like it's a racing seat, but it's not. It's very comfortable. And this bloody hoodie is, why do I choose to wear a hoodie during a review? It strangles me. I do love the display that this Range Rover has. It's all digital, the screen. No more analog crap, people. All digital. Everything's digital. There's a lot of bloody nuff-nuffs on the road today. It's always typical that you borrow someone's car and suddenly every bad driver in the immediate vicinity is just swarming you like a bad rash. Cruising at highway speed, the car handles really nice. Like, there's just nothing quite like driving a big Sherman tank down the expressway, especially a supercharged one at that. And this wood grain finish, and this padding around the steering wheel, it's almost like a stress ball. You just want to squeeze it the whole time. It's actually quite bloody distracting. Don't come on to the expressway, ladies and gentlemen, in the merge lane doing 30 mile an hour. No cop in their right mind is going to try and ping you for merging at a good speed, okay? The merging at 30 mile an hour is ridiculous. Don't do it. It's freaking annoying. Now, I have forgotten to do it lately, and I apologize. Super big shout out to our first responders and military for all they do for allowing us the freedoms and luxuries that we have today. I will say I just tested the sound system, and it is phenomenal in typical Range Rover fashion. I don't do that part anymore on the vlog because YouTube and UMG get all upset if it's one of their songs, even if it's freaking 10 seconds. It's ridiculous. I don't get it. I'm not trying to make money off your song. I could give a shit about your stupid ass hip hop song or whatever the hell it is, but let's not go there. This is not a political vlog. I'm just letting you guys know that the sound system in this thing kicks some serious balls. Just enjoying the beautiful day that this December month has put on for us, just so we could review this 2016 Range Rover. It's a glorious day, the sun's out, Christmas music blaring everywhere, and people getting around in ugly sweaters. It's just the perfect day for a car review. It's cruising in the Range Rover. Any of you farm animals out there can hear me, because there's no one else up here. I'm in the hills, people. In the hills. In the hills. All right, so let's slow down a bit from a standing start, switch it over to sports mode, and take off. Damn, jeez, this thing gets up. Let me tell you, I'm a bit surprised by that. For a massive SUV, the power in this thing is unbelievable. I mean, that definitely feels like 500 horsepower. There's no doubt about that. But that was a little bit surprising, I'll be honest with you. Damn, bloody beautiful. Shit. Well, there was never, ever going to be a concern about whether or not I liked this Range Rover. That was a given. I don't know of a Range Rover that they've made since I've been driving that I didn't love. And this one is no exception. It's absolutely gorgeous. I love it to death. It's comfortable, the ride, the handling, the braking, the power, it has everything. I mean, it really does. It has all the options, and I mean, you could fit bloody 40 people in that back seat. I mean, it's massive, absolutely massive, and that's the benefit of the long wheelbase Range Rover. My time in the Range Rover has come to an end, so thank you for tuning in, my friends. I do appreciate it. I have unfortunately got to go Christmas shopping with my wife. Oh, that's going to be horrible. But anyway, until next time, hooroo, abracadabra, this vlog is over.